Hi again, fellow unlicensed thinkers. Today, I'm going to talk about something a little bit weird, and it is why you should embrace your inner narcissist. But before I get into that, if you could reach the like button for me, I can't quite get it from here. Thank you. All right, so narcissism and pride for oneself or love for oneself are often confused a little bit because usually what it has to do with is jealousy or something like that. You know, we see someone else being prideful or boastful or something like that, and we go, oh God, what a narcissist. But to me, narcissism is more on a spectrum. And I know there's a clinical definition, and once you cross the certain line, you know, they determine that you're a narcissist. But I mean, the whole psychology thing is kind of funny because it's all very, it's all made up by that particular psychologist that might be looking after somebody. So anyways, where that line is, who knows? But what happens is that we want this healthy level of narcissism. We don't want to think of ourselves as being terrible and, you know, not worth anything or whatever. So we want this healthy level that says, you know, I'm great, I'm deserving, and so on. And so when we look at everyone being prideful or boastful or whatever as being a narcissist, what we do is we admonish a lot of these traits that could be beneficial to us. And so we have, we have all these traits like this pride, this joy, this happiness, this, you know, I deserve that, I'm great, I'm wonderful, I can do this, all these kind of things. They all fall into this undesirable category. And we say, oh, when we see somebody else doing that, that's bad. Well, that means that if it's bad, then our subconscious says, well, it's bad for us too. So now I don't feel right feeling pride, feeling like I'm awesome, all that kind of stuff. But I do feel awesome, and you should too. So that's where you should embrace that inner narcissist. And narcissism isn't always bad. And we'll kind of get to more of that in a second. But I want to first consider someone who is high in narcissistic traits. So they want to be praised by everyone. They want to be loved by everyone. They want everyone to tell them how great they are. Well, okay, that doesn't make them a bad person. What if they become very successful at helping people so that everyone looks to them and says, wow, that guy is so awesome. Do you see how many people he helped? And it's like, yeah, I did. I did help a lot of people. I'm pretty damn cool. And so is there anything wrong with them? Have they done anything bad? I mean, so long as they haven't, like, you know, scammed anyone or whatever along the way, is there anything wrong with them wanting to be lavished with praise over the things that they've done? And I don't think so. I think that's perfectly fine. I mean, I do this channel. I wrote a book, soon to be published, by the way. and I fully admit that if someone gets a benefit from my work, from what I say here on my channel, from what I may say in my book, that's all fantastic. I'm gonna take the pride of that. I'm gonna be like, that's great. And if it's 10 people that are helped, cool. If it's 100 or 1,000 or 1,000,000, oh my God, even better. I'm not gonna say, oh no, it wasn't a big deal. I'm gonna say, yeah, I'm pretty damn smart. I did a good job. These are great things. Go ahead and lavish me with pride. Does that make me an evil narcissist? Because that is part of the reason for doing the work that I do, is that I love hearing from people that I do help and saying, hey, that was awesome. That was a good idea. That was, you know, really smart. No, I'm not going to deny myself that. Not a chance. I love hearing it. And you should too with the things that you do. Absolutely. You should feel that worthiness. So things like, you know, we always associate narcissists with gaslighting, but gaslighting and other nasty behaviors like that, those are just asshole things to do. Those aren't necessarily because the person is a narcissist. Now, they can go together, but narcissism and evil are not necessarily connected. Like I said, they can be. So someone can be a narcissist and be evil. Someone can be evil and not be a narcissist. Someone can be a narcissist and be a good person. And that's a whole lot of S sounds coming out of my mouth in this video. Oh my God. I feel like I'm hissing my whole way through this. So someone could be on that really high on that narcissism spectrum, but wanting to do good things for people. Excuse me. So if we go to like these prideful things that people say, so someone who, you know, say they work out and they go and they flex in the mirror all the time. And any of us who have been to the gym, we know who these people are. Well, you could say, what a narcissist. Well, maybe. But what's so wrong with that? What's wrong with that person standing in front of the mirror and admiring the work that they've done? What's wrong with that person showing off the work that they've done to other people? They could actually be encouraging others to work out more. They could be showing what is possible, showing that you can do that. You can have that muscle. If they're showing off their car or their money, well, okay, so what's wrong with that? I mean, there's not really a problem with somebody doing that in my mind. And in fact, what they're doing is they're showing you that you could have this Lamborghini or you could have all this money to throw around. And find something to do that provides a benefit to the world and get that money in a good way and then be proud of doing it. Show it off, say, hey, look what I did. You know how I got this money? Tell everybody about it. Be boastful if you want. And someone who, like I said, someone who does good things. So say there's someone who has donated a lot of money or created an organization that feeds kids in some third world country or something. I don't know. Is there any reason that they shouldn't be prideful and boastful about the great thing that they've done? I don't see anything wrong with it. I think that level of narcissism is fantastic. That they, a lot of times, are showing everyone else that success is possible by not hiding it. They normalize it. They make it okay for you to go and succeed, so long as you're not admonishing those traits of being prideful and boastful and being super successful and all of that kind of stuff. So there are a lot of people that we would call narcissists that are getting a lot of stuff. They do really well for themselves. And that's not necessarily bad. I mean, again, if they're evil and they're assholes, well, you know, hopefully they won't do that. But you don't have to be evil and an asshole to get the same stuff that the people that you call narcissists. So just be careful of what traits you're admonishing. Admonish the evil traits, 100%. If they are hurting people, if they are being mean to people, if they are being unkind, absolutely admonish those traits. But being successful, bragging about your success, having money, flexing in the mirror, none of these things are actually bad. So why do these narcissists get so much stuff? Well, it's because they feel worthy of it. They feel like they deserve it. They feel like I should be getting all of this stuff. And so this applies to like manifestation and just hard work in general and what your subconscious allows you to believe and to accomplish. So being humble doesn't help anything. It doesn't really get you anywhere. But feeling like you deserve things, feeling like you should have them, that gets you everywhere. That helps you with, like I said, the metaphysical manifestation and the physical manifestations of what you think you should go for, what you think you should be able to get and deserve. And so embrace that inner narcissist and be friends with them. Don't be friends with evil. Be friends with the narcissist that says, I'm great, I'm wonderful. And probably don't take it too high up the narcissism scale, because then we get into a little bit of weird territory that's not necessarily evil, but it's not exactly healthy. So let's try to avoid going too high on that scale, but definitely you want to have some of that narcissism. You want to allow yourself to feel worthy and admonish those evil acts, those evil behaviors, but don't admonish the self-worth and the empowerment that come along with feeling like you're great, feeling like you did great things and being prideful. So let me know what you guys think in the comments. Be sure to hit like, of course, and share the video. Have a great day.